Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. The problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the third practice test in the new SAT study guide for the redesigned SAT, right? That will start from March of 2016. So this is problem number 11, practice test 3, section 3, no calculator. Okay, so this is a geometry problem. It gives you three line segments joining intersecting at the same point, at one point. So it says lines K, L, and M intersect at a point if X plus Y is equal to U plus V, which of the following must be true? So X, Y, U, and W represent the variables that show the degree value, right? The degree, the angles, in other words, right? So X is Y, U, and W. All six variables here are angle measures. Okay, so it says if X plus Y is equal to U plus W, which of the following must be true? So let's see. So first of all, since these three lines intersect at one point, that means that U and Y are vertical angles, and as you know, vertical angles must be equal. Okay, so now if vertical angles are equal, we can substitute the value of U for the Y, and we're going to have U on the left side as well. So now since U appear on both sides, we can cancel them out, subtract them, and we're left with X is equal to W, right? So let's see, X and W, so these two must be the same, equal in measure, in angle measure, right? So X angle measure X is equal to angle measure W. Now take a look here. Since W is equal to Z, and how do we know that? Because they're a pair of vertical angles too, right? That means that X and Z must be equal because X is equal to W as well, right? So X must be equal to Z, and that's exactly what statement one reads, right? So this must be the correct statement. So let's talk about the statement 2. The statement 2, says Y is equal to W. So let's see how this works. So we already know that X and W are equal, so that means Z and T are equal because X and T are vertical angles and Y and Z are vertical angles. So now they're saying Y is equal to W. Now in order for Y to be equal to W, That means that all angles must be 60 degrees each, right? Because this whole circle would make 360 degrees, right? So if you start at this line and you go all the way around and you wind up on the same point, you will have traveled 360 degrees. So that means since there are six angles, that means all of them must be the same in value in order for the Y to be equal to W. Because we have four equal angle measures, right? We have the same angle measures. Z, T, W, and X are all the same, right? They're equal in measure. So that means in order for Y and U to step in and be equal to W, each of them, that means all of these angles must be 60 degrees, and that is not shown here, right? That is not given, because it's not given in the problem that all of them are 60 degrees, because if these four angles, X, W, Z, and T are equal, they could be, I don't know, some other degree. They could be 50 degrees each, right? And 50 times 4 would be 200, and you would have 160 degrees, and you could have had 80 degrees for the Y and 80 degrees for the U, right? So that disproves the statement that Y is equal to W, right? It's only valid when all of these angles measure 60 degrees, but we don't know what they measure because all we're given is X plus Y is equal to U plus W. Okay? So that is not necessarily true. So let's talk about the last choice. Z is equal to T. Well, we already know this because since X is equal to T and W is equal to Z and X was equal to W, right? Because X plus W, this angle, right, that is made by the sum of X and W will equal the sum made by Z and T, right? And since x is equal to t and w is equal to z and w is equal to x, then z must equal t to t. Okay? So let's see how this works. Well, yeah, this is my way of doing this. The College Board is actually giving you a different approach. They're giving you the sum of x plus y plus z is equal to w plus u plus t, which is absolutely true, because both sums will measure 180 degrees, right? So x plus y plus z is equal to 180, and w plus u plus t is equal to 180. Now, since x plus y is equal u plus w, you could have subtracted this amount on both sides from this lengthy sum of three angles on each side of the equation, and you would have left with z is equal to t, right? That's how they do it. But my way also works because it's logical and it makes sense. So the answer choice, the correct answer choice to this problem, disqualifies this statement 2. So it means that the only valid statements here will be 1 and 3 only, okay? Because 2 is not necessarily true. So choice B is the correct answer choice to this problem. So if you found this video useful, and if you want to get lots of math practice before you take your first redesigned SAT exam issue, if you want to take exams under time conditions, and remember, time conditions is very important because you're going to have pressure when you take the real exam, visit revisedsat.com. There's a prep system that you can join for free. You do not have to pay anything to start practicing. There's a free trial. You will take exams under time conditions. You will have your own user account with login information, username, and password. Okay? Watch the video in detail on revisedsat.com. The link to this website is right below the video. You will see how your user account will look like. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care.